So dear students, I am hoping that you have done with your practice work and assignment also. So here in the next video, I mean in this video, I am going to start is what? The next topic, this is nothing but vector integral calculus. Right? So what is the vector integral calculus? So first of all, I must tell you that there is nothing vector integral calculus, there is nothing vector in vector integral calculus. I mean, all the things must be the scalar form, right? So what's the vector integral calculus? In this, we need to have first line integral. So please write down line integral. Or you can say single integral, line integral or single integral. So this is line integral or single integral, dear students. So what I am having is I is equal to, I am having integration f dot dl, or you can write integration c f dot dr also. See, f dot dl or f dot dr, no problem at all. Okay, so here we are having f, vector f, I'm having like f1 I cap plus f2 j cap plus f3 k cap, where f1, f2, f3 are the functions of x, y and z, or it can be a constant also. Now what is r? So we have done with the r. What is r? It is nothing but x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, correct? So what is the dr? If I am having vector dr, so it is nothing but dx I cap, dy j cap, and yes, you are absolutely correct, dz k cap, fine. So it is the open line integral, right? If I am closing it, so it can be a closed line integral also, there is no problem, right? So let's multiply these two for what we have the integration. So I am having here I is equal to, you can see I is equal to, I am having the integration, and see f1 dot dr is what? F1 I dot I is 1, so f1 dx plus we are having what? F2 dy plus we are having what? F3 dz, dear students. So this is what the integral, and normally in our gate examination, there is always xy plane. In general, there is xy plane, and for xy plane, z is equal to 0 and also dz is equal to 0, then the value of I will be, the value of I will be integration c. See, here we can say dz is equal to 0, that means what? F1 dx plus f2 dy, fine. So this is the value of the integral. So with the help of, how can we solve it, right? So with the help of c, with the help of c, we'll use only one variable, only one variable, because here is only one integral, here is only one integral, so we should have only one variable. Then how can we convert the one variable integration? With the help of this c, with the help of this curve. Okay, so if I'm saying I is equal to, it is a closed integral. If I am saying it is the closed integral f1 or f dot dr, let us suppose I am having f dot dr. It is a closed integral f dot dr and closed curve c we are having here. Let us suppose this equation number 1, right? So in line integral or single integral, if I am having the vector point function with dr, so by dot product we are always having what? The scalar function, right? So in the integral calculus, the chapter number 3, we have done with this kind of integral so many times because it is a single integral, right? So now in the application point of view, we can see if I is equal to the integral of f dot dr, and here we are having f as a force, so you can write if f is a force, right? If f is a force, then this equation number 1 gives the work done by the force. If f is a force, then equation number 1 give gives the work done by the force, and if it is a flow, if F gives the flow, then equation number 1 gives what? It is the circulation of the flow. So here we are having the equation number 1, and remember one thing, if line integral is closed, right, if line integral is closed, it converts the surface. That means if line enclosed, if line is closed, it forms the surface. If surface is closed, right, if you are having a matchbox, if you are having a matchbox, take 4 matches out from the box and have a square, right? You can have a square. The square is nothing but what? Closed lines, correct? So the square is the surface, and matchbox itself is a volume. So when surface closes, it creates a volume. When line closes, it creates a surface, right? Okay. So this is nothing but the line integral. We will have the example also, we will have the booklet question also, but now let us have number 2, which is nothing but surface integral. So I'm having surface integral. So surface integrals, right? Surface integrals. So what is surface integrals? It is nothing but double integral we are having here, double integral. So I'm having double integral. So surface integral, or we can say double integral, correct? Surface integral or double integral. So what is the surface integral in vector calculus? I'm having what? Double integration surface a vector, and yes, the ds. So what is the ds? You can see I is equal to the double integration. I'm having s, a is nothing but a vector point function. So I'm writing here a dot ds is nothing but n cap and ds. Then what is the n cap? So here you can see, if it is a surface S, the derivative form is ds, the strip can be a ds, and n cap is nothing but the direction of the plane. So we are having n cap here. N cap is nothing but unit normal vector, which represents, which is perpendicular to the surface and represents the direction of the surface, So here n cap is nothing but, it is a unit normal vector, of course it is a perpendicular to the surface. So if my hand is a surface, so what is the unit normal vector? It represents the direction of this surface, the direction of my hand, and which is the perpendicular to the hand, right? It is the perpendicular to the hand. So let us have these some planes, right? Let us suppose I'm having xy plane. This is our xy plane, the most popular plane for the gate examination, right? For the question of the gate examination, I'm having yz plane, and let us suppose I'm having the xy, yz and zx plane. Okay, for xy plane, if I'm having ds, it is nothing but dx dy, and yes, the perpendicular for xy, let us suppose we are having here x and y axis, this is what x and y axis, and this is the perpendicular axis, right? So for x and y axis, the perpendicular is z. See, for x and y axis, the perpendicular is z, and what is the n cap for z? What is the n cap for z? That means what? K cap. It is nothing but the unit vector along z axis. For yz, the ds must be dy dz, and yes, the unit vector should be yz, that means y and z, that means x is the perpendicular, so I cap, correct? For zx, we have dx and dz, and yes, for zx is the perpendicular y direction, so y direction we have what? J cap. Fine. So for xy, normally we'll have for xy plane, that is nothing but n cap is nothing but k cap. So let us have this example for xy plane. So I'm writing here for xy plane. So you can see what? The integration I is equal to for xy plane. Let us suppose I am having the value of A from my very first video. The value of A must be AX I cap for first video. From first video, I am having AY J cap, correct? And plus AZ K cap, right? Now, dot, what we are having here, it is the XY plane. if it is xy plane, right, I am writing for xy plane, correct? So if it is xy plane, this is the x and y plane, then here we are having what? N cap is nothing but k cap n dx n dy. So now if k and k multiplied, we are having I, the surface integral or the double integral for xy plane must be this I value is 0, this j value is 0, what we are getting is az, k dot k is 1, and we are having here dx and dy. So my dear student, in vector integral calculus there is no vector. You can see here is no vector. That means what? From the chapter number 3, which have been done by us, that is nothing but the integration, we should have the integral term, right? We should integrate it, that's it. For double integration, we should take the strip, and by taking the strip, there is an integration. We should have the formula for the integration, and again the formula for the integration, that's enough. And again, the very important thing is what? The most important thing is what? The limits. The limits by tracing the curve, right? So we can have the integral limits, and then after we just need to have the integration, and integration part we have done with the chapter number 3, dear students, right? So now this is what? Line integral. The second is what? Surface integral. The third and very important thing is what? Volume integral. Volume integral. So volume integral is nothing but triple integral, right? So triple integral, volume integral, or we can say triple integral. Again, triple integral, that means what? 1, 2 and 3 we are having V, and this is nothing but the scalar point function. Any scalar point function we are having x, y and z, and yes, it is what? dv or dx, dy and dz. This is a scalar or mod value of a vector, right? Or mod value of a vector. This is scalar, or we can say any mod value of a vector quantity. So again, in the line integration, at last we can say in the line integration we are having vector integral calculus, but for the line integration we do not have the vector quantity here. Again, for the surface integration, here we are having vector, but yes, we do not have the vector quantity here. And again, for the volume integration, we don't have the vector quantity here. That means what? It means what? We have all done in the chapter number 3, that is the integral calculus. That means what? We just need to have the integration, we just need to have the conversion. That means by dot product we can convert the vector form in the scalar form, and then after we'll integrate it. So it is not very much important for the gate examination, right? Then what is important? If I'm saying vector integral calculus is important, and if I'm saying it is not important, then what is the important? Correct? Then what is the important thing? So dear students, the important thing is what? We will deal the important thing in our next video. That's the important thing. And what is that? It is the relationship between what? Line surface and volume integral. So line surface and volume integral. So you can have a point is moving. If a point is moving, it creating a line, right? If point is moving, it creating a line or curve. If point is moving, it creating a line or curve. That means the path, right? The path. Okay, if I'm closing this path, you can see here we are having the our EIR1 from NIT Raipur, Shivam Singh, right? You can see here, this is the line, correct? This is the line, and this is the line we have, this is the line. So we have four lines closed here, correct? We have four line closed here. Zoom. We have four line closed here, right? This is what? A single line, this is the line, and here we are having line. So four line closed here. If it is closed, then it form a surface, correct? If lines are closed or curves are closed, if we are having the closed line or closed surface, closed line line, that means what? We have this surface. The surface is open, correct? If I close that surface, that means what? If I am closing the surface, right? I am having the six surfaces. One, two, see. We can see like this. If I am having a battery, right? I am having here a battery. Okay. So this is what? A single surface. Again here, single surface. So if I am closing this surface, I am having a single surface here, then here, then here, 3, then 4, then 5, and then 6. So 6 surfaces. Here I am having 6 surfaces. When I am closing this surface, we have the volume, correct? when line integral and surface integral and volume integral are related, if line is closed, it forms an open surface. If surface is closed, it forms a volume. Then there is a relationship, correct? So we'll, in next video, we'll deal with the relationship when line closes and surface closes. When line closes, it converts into a surface, and when surface closes, it converts into the volume, correct? So for the line and surface integral relationship, line must be closed, and for the surface and volume integral relationship, the surface must be closed. So in our next video, we'll have the relationship. This is nothing but Stokes, Green and Gauss theorem, right? So directly you can start with the next video, that is nothing but relationship between line, surface and volume integral.